As we all know, on March 8th, when Governor Corbett gave his address, his budgetary address, he proposed maintaining funding for the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts budget at $8,262,000 because he, like many of us across the Commonwealth, recognizes that the arts and culture make an important contribution to Pennsylvania's economy and tourism industry. In fact, Pennsylvania's First Lady, Susan Corbett, as chair of the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, recently visited the Settlement School in Philadelphia to view firsthand its preschool arts enrichment program that helps low-income children develop their arts and artistic skills. Now, in direct contrast to the budget, the governor's budget proposal in March, a few weeks ago, the Republican-controlled House passed the budget, which slashed the Pennsylvania Coalition of the Arts by almost 70%. And this cut would lower Pennsylvania from 28th to 46th in the nation per capita funding for the arts. And this is important. This is very important because the arts and culture is a job creator and an economic engine for the state and for the region. And I think that's important because not everybody always understands that. And I've had this conversation with many folks, and the Democratic, the delegation leader, Senator Kitchen, a few years ago when we had this issue in 2009 during the budgetary crisis, really helped focus us on this issue, that it's not just folks coming in and enjoying arts and culture, but it's the economic benefits that go along with that and the educational benefits that go along with that too. Reaching out to children across the Commonwealth, across Philadelphia, giving them the arts to help enrich their overall educational experience. You can't put a price tag on that. So, you know, again, there's a very strong and important economic component to this and a very vital educational component to this that if we don't recognize that, we're going to lose a very, very important asset to our community and to the Commonwealth. Now, according to the Philadelphia Cultural Alliance, this sector supports 62,000 jobs and generates almost $300 million in state and local tax revenues. Again, right back to the issue of economic generator, job creator, an asset that we already have here in Pennsylvania, and the fact that we, that a body of this chamber, a body of this building, Republican-controlled House, wants to slash that funding by nearly 70%, clearly identifies that they do not recognize the importance of the arts and the breadth of the outreach that the arts does, not only, of course, in Philadelphia, but across the Commonwealth. Additionally, some additional information, the cultural sector pumps $2 billion of spending into our economy. And this situation, the situation right now for the arts, this budget that was just recently passed a few weeks ago, is dire. And I'm not exaggerating when I say that. This is a serious, serious problem. Just as serious as it was in 2009 when they attempted to go after the arts funding again, and we were able to, through the leadership of folks behind me and the Philadelphia delegation got together, along with our leadership in the Senate, and we were able to stop those cuts. Over the past 2 years, the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts has seen its granting budget nearly cut in half. And that's very significant as well, too. And we cannot afford an additional 70% cut at this time. So now is not the time to walk away from our communities and arts and our culture. The arts and culture makes a very vital and important contribution to communities around the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And I want to stress that. This is not just a Philadelphia issue. Of course, we have so many of Pennsylvania's arts and culture institutions are located within the city of Philadelphia. But again, throughout the Commonwealth, the arts clearly is an economic generator and something that goes to children, that goes to educational performance, and it's something that is vital to our economy. We can't let that slip away. This is a creative industry that returns jobs and revenues to the state, and it's vulnerable right now at a point in time when we cannot be doing anything to disturb or disrupt economic generators in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. I think it's important. I was watching a press conference yesterday, and I saw a colleague of mine in the House, Brendan Boyle, and he talked about where is the Republican House jobs plan. The Senate Democrats have a jobs plan. The Republicans in the House have no jobs plan, but instead they're going after important economic generators like this and other types of legislation that really don't do what Pennsylvania needs right now, and that is to move forward with economic growth and job development. So I wanted to bring folks together today to talk about these cuts, to talk about how important this is, And I'm going to give an opportunity for a lot of folks here today to say a few words. The first person I'm going to introduce is Senator Mike Stack from Philadelphia, and he will be followed by the delegation head, Shirley Kitchen of Philadelphia as well, too. Senator Stack?
Well, thanks, everybody, for being here. And I just want to thank Senator Farnese for his leadership on this issue, and thank all my colleagues for standing up on this issue. And what we talk about in this state is, we always say Pennsylvania's got to be more competitive with the states that surround us, and we're in a global economy where we compete around the world with other countries. And one of the areas where we have been good and strong is in the area of the arts and culture. We can rival New York in arts and culture if we do everything that we should. Instead, what the Republican leadership in the House has said is, let's not go in a positive direction, let's go in a negative direction. Let's cut an area where we can be an economic generator, as Senator Farnese has talked about. So what they have done is they've decided on the idea of investing in our future, saying that it's not worthwhile to invest in the arts and culture, which, as Senator Farnese has said, generate millions of dollars on their own in our state. The other thing we don't talk about is tourism is, I think, our second highest industry in Pennsylvania. Each and every one of the arts institutions or culture institutions, whether it be museums or theater, could quantify in tourism dollars what they can bring in. That's in hotels and restaurants and all the other small businesses that benefit. So there really couldn't be a more wrong-headed thing to do than to cut arts and culture. And I want to say that we've got to fight that kind of wrong-headed idea. We've got to be concerned about investing in our future. And if you invest in arts and culture in Pennsylvania, you're going to be investing in our future. So once again, I'm happy to be standing here with my colleagues. We look forward to fighting on this issue. Once again, Senator Farnese, thanks for getting folks together and your leadership on this issue. And we look forward to making sure that we got our priorities in order and invest in arts and culture. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Stack. Next, I'm going to call up Senator Shirley Kitchen, who is the head of the Philadelphia delegation. And I just want to point out again the leadership that Senator Kitchen shows, not only on a daily basis, but specifically on this issue. She knew it's how important it was. She recognized very early, like many of us did in 2009, how important it was to go after this and act quickly and swiftly. And through her leadership and the leadership of others, we were able to prevent those devastating cuts in 2009. Senator Kitchen.
Good morning. Thank you, Senator Farnese, for your leadership on this very important issue. I represent the Philadelphia delegation, and each and every member, of course, Senator Farnese here today, support full funding for the arts here in Pennsylvania. And of course, it is an economic engine, as stated earlier, but do we realize what an impact it has on the lives of children and youth, and especially children who do not have access to such things as the art museum, to the ballet, to art, to music. This is what the art has meant to children from low-income families and from children who may not even have access. They come into the communities, they provide different types of learning. They also have a mobile, a science mobile, where they travel around the state to give children exposure. And this allows them to grow and develop into the kind of person that we want to see, so that they can find their place in the world, so that they know where they belong. And when this is taken away, this is when we see children develop problems that we could have prevented. Only if we support the arts so they can support the work that they are doing, which is worth millions and millions and millions of dollars more than what they even received when they had full funding. So we are requesting that the governor's proposal for funding for the arts be recognized, and that we support his amount and not the amount that the Republicans are recommending. This will severely, severely hurt the children of Pennsylvania. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Kitchen. And just want to just recognize some, first of all, he's not with us today, but Senator Anthony Williams, our good friend, and he's a the Democratic appointee to the board of the Council of the Arts. Senator Williams is not here with us, but I make sure that we recognize him as well, too. And I also want to recognize, I believe, Robert Welsh is here as well today, the executive director of Jump Street, a nonprofit community-based arts incubator in Harrisburg, and as well as Judy Linsz Ross, who is the director of marketing for the Westmoreland Museum of Art as well, is with us as well here today. They're going to be coming up and making some comments as well, too. Next, I'd like to bring up Senator Jay Costa, who is the Democratic leader. Senator Costa, along with our leadership, has made it very clear that the funding of the line from Senator, Governor Corbett's budget is what we should be supporting, and has given us his assurances that he will fight to restore that line, and that is what is the appropriate. So I want to thank him for his leadership on that. I'm going to call him up to the podium for some remarks as well. Senator Costa.
Thank you very much, Senator Farnese. Senator Farnese is correct. The Senate Democrats have working with the conversation we're having with our colleagues on the other side of the aisle have made it a priority that we restore funding to the arts at the governor's level. And I want to thank Larry for, again, bringing all the arts advocates who are here today to make certain that we continue to be work very hard to make sure that we connect with the Republican colleagues to make sure we put the resources together. You know, Senator Farnese talked about the economic impact, and he's laid it out very articulately about the economic impact in the southeastern part of the state. The same thing applies to the southwestern part of the state where I hail from. But I don't think anybody can say it any better than Senator Kitchen about the manner in which arts impact the lives and the quality of lives of folks, but most importantly on our students. I've had the privilege before Senator Williams of serving on the Council on the Arts for a period of 8 years, and we saw firsthand our arts and education programs that allow for artists to go into our schools and develop arts programs that were outstanding. And exposure to the arts of children plays a major, major dividend in the quality of life and how they view themselves and how they do, quite frankly, on things like SAT scores and how they perform in the classrooms. There's a tremendous number of studies that reflect all that. And she laid it out very clearly. But let me talk to you about the double whammy that's going to take place in this Commonwealth's budget. If we don't have resources to the arts to drive into education in particular, with the cuts that are taking place to our school districts, at the end of the day, school districts are going to be eliminating a lot of arts programs across this Commonwealth. It's inevitable because of the funding cuts. So not only are we losing arts dollars as it relates to the amount of money being able to drive into arts and education programs, we're also losing arts programs, a variety of arts programs across the Commonwealth. We have to do everything we can to restore this line. We've put it in our budget priority list to make certain that we try to do something. Go back to where the governor, we think the governor made a thoughtful decision about where we needed to be with respect to the quality of the arts, and we need to recognize that as being an appropriate number and fight to that end. At the end of the day, it's about the economic impact, it's about the impact it has on children, and it's about the quality of life issues in this Commonwealth and what direction we want to go. And I think that's what we need to do. And I'm pleased that my colleagues from southwestern Pennsylvania and the southeastern part of the state are working together to really address an issue that impacts every single community in this Commonwealth. When I was on the Council on the Arts, we had our local share program where we would work with local share folks. And when I first got there, there were only two counties that were blue, where we had local partners, community partners. And now, and that's where we were driving out dollars, largely to a handful of counties. I can stand here today and tell you that every single county receives dollars because of the work that's being done by the Council on the Arts folks to make sure every community experiences resources. And what that means is that there's arts activity taking place in every one of those counties across this Commonwealth as it was meant to be. I appreciate my colleagues here working together with us, and especially Senator Farnese for his leadership on this issue. Thanks, buddy.
Thank you, Senator Costa. Let me also now bring up Senator, I'm going to bring up the Appropriations Chairman from the Democratic Appropriations Chairman, Senator Hughes, and he will have some remarks, and he'll be followed by Senator Daylin. Senator Hughes.
Thank you, Senator Farnese, and I also want to thank Larry for his really good leadership in this issue and trying to make sure that as we close on the last 3 weeks of the budget process here in Harrisburg, that this issue not be lost in the budget conversations. Yeah. Senator Costa indicated in his comments that we have made this on our, if you will, short list of priorities that we like to see funded at the appropriate level, which is the level that the governor introduced in his budget proposal back on March 8th. I think we need to say clearly that we have found the money out of a lot of diligent work by all the members up here. We have found the money to make it available in Harrisburg so that we can fund this and to fund this at the appropriate level. We are running by June 30th a $600 million budget surplus, so the dollars are available to be utilized to fund this program. We found the money. The money is there. There's no question that we should make this a priority, get this done. It's a huge economic impact. The arts is much, you know, we celebrate our sports teams in Pennsylvania ad nauseum, and they should be celebrated. We've got great sports teams in every athletic endeavor. But the truth of the matter is that the arts are a greater economic engine than our sports teams. And it's shown time and time again that we have the numbers here that indicate that, and it is important and vital for us to do this. And I can speak very specifically of a recent festival that was celebrated in Philadelphia. And it was the Philadelphia International Festival of the Arts. For about a five-week or six-week period, we had arts organizations from all around the world, come to Philadelphia throughout the entire southeastern Pennsylvania region. And all kinds of incredible activity was done. It was beautiful, from dance to art to theater to anything that you can think of was celebrated in the region. This was celebrated and written about and talked about internationally. All over the world, everyone was talking about Philadelphia and the arts. And that's a huge economic impact for our region, but also the arts celebrates the best in us. When we have an enlightened community that deals with the arts, that deals with our creative side, we become a better civilization, we become a better state. So I'd like to make sure that we all understand that this is important, that we're standing up for this, that it's vital, and that the money exists to support the arts across the entire state of Pennsylvania. And we stand, all of us collectively, to make sure that this gets done. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Hughes. I want to all bring up now Senator Daylin Leach. Senator Daylin Leach was one of the folks that joined myself and others, Senator Stack, and the Philadelphia delegation in 2009 to oppose the arts tax back then. Senator Leach.
Thank you very much. And I thank Senator Farnese for his leadership. As Larry mentioned, I remember standing on a subway, at the top of the subway, fighting another brilliant Republican idea, which was to tax the arts. We were successful in defeating that. The fact is that some people just don't get it. They don't get the importance of the arts for our community. But I think that the health of a community can be judged by the health of its arts and its artistic program. And we've seen that time and time again. You know, Philadelphia has the most murals, thanks to the mural arts program, of any city in the world. And that makes a huge difference in neighborhoods, everything from beautification to crime reduction to educational inspiration. I know in my own district how Theater Horizon and other arts groups that are coming to Norristown are literally changing that city. Arts are the best of us. They are the what Maslow would call the self-actualization of humanity. And they take, as Senator Hughes said, I think, such a tiny percentage of the budget. And to cut them so dramatically, to me, is abandoning what should be the vision of the future of Pennsylvania. You know, when people want to decide where to locate a company, unlike how some people feel, they don't just think about what kind of tax break will we get. They also want to know about quality of life. They want to know if it's a clean community. They want to know if it's a safe community. They want to know if the roads are good and so forth. But they also want to know, is this a community with culture? Is this a community with arts? Is this a community that has museums, that has plays, that has all kinds of artistic things? Because my family's going to want to participate in that. And so I think if we want Pennsylvania to become a destination state, we've got to invest more in the arts, not pull back from our investment in the arts. So I look forward to fighting with all of my colleagues up here today to restore that funding and continue making Pennsylvania a destination city. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Leach. We're running out of time, but I do want to bring up Judy Linsz Ross for some remarks, and because at the hour we have, the session is ready to begin, literally in a few moments. So, Judy, if you can come up real quick.
Okay.
So there she is right there.
Thank you, Senator Farnese, for this opportunity. My name is Judy Ross. I live in Greensburg in Westmoreland County, and I have a job in the arts. Simply stated, we had all the staff at the Westmoreland Museum of American Arts say these few words, and within 1 hour we were able to post a video on Facebook and YouTube, and we shared it with all our constituents. We used, all we did was use a flip camera. Really easy to do. We've sent email blasts, we've done Facebook posts, we've tweeted. We even had our visitors sign our giant petition, which just went with our director of development to see Senator Ward, and have collected over 200 signatures. So the Westmoreland Museum of American Art is located in Greensburg and employs 14 full-time and 19 part-time employees. Senate District 39 is home to 339 arts-related businesses that employ nearly 1,200 people. In the last 2 years, the exhibitions we've had at the Westmoreland have had an economic impact on the region of over $1 million. I collect zip codes from everybody who comes through the door. Combine this with the impact from the other arts organizations in our community, like the Westmoreland Symphony, Stage Right, the Seton Hill Performing Arts Center, and the Summer Sounds Free Concerts in the Park series, this number increases significantly. In addition to serving over 22,000 visitors each year, the museum serves thousands off-site through school and community outreach. In the last 5 years, nearly 14,000 students have toured the museum, and this represents a growth of 88%. As the schools are cutting back on the arts programs, they're looking to the museums and other cultural organizations to help them meet their state-mandated curriculum standards, so we do that. We only charge a minimal fee for school tours and outreach, and most of the time we waive the fee if schools are unable to pay. We even go look for funding to help them pay for their buses to get them to the museum. This year alone, nearly 1,000 students participated at no cost to the school district or the students. We are in the process of an expansion planning process at the museum, and we did some market research 2 years ago. And we found out that the Westmoreland Museum of American Art has a strong presence in the community, and the visitors believe we do an excellent job of serving our community, and that we're one of the best cultural attractions in southwestern Pennsylvania. Two-thirds of the respondents strongly agreed that art museums contribute substantially to the quality of life in their communities, and that they place a very high value on having art museums in their community. Since 1999, the Westmoreland has received nearly $538,000 in support from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts. The majority of that went to general operating support, which directly supports our 33 staff members who carry out our mission and our programs. My name is Judy Ross. I live in Greensburg in Westmoreland County, and I'm proud to have a job in the arts. Thank you.
Thank you, Judy. Next, I'd like to bring up Robert Welsh for some remarks.
Hi, folks. I'm Bob Welsh, director of Jump Street. On the other end of the spectrum, we're three folks holed up in a little office over on Cameron Street. The Pennsylvania Council on the Arts does a lot to keep us going. Art for art's sake is not what we do. It's rather arts processes, and through those processes that we strive for three things: workforce development, discipline, creativity, and community dignity. On the workforce development side, the council supports our AND magazine. And based on their work and their portfolios in AND magazine, students that have worked on the project have received over $250,000 in scholarships from state, private, and out-of-state colleges and universities. Our design and furniture building program has, where city students build furniture for VA hospitals, shelters, libraries. This is a community service project, but it's also transferable job skills, workforce development. Our 100 Voices program, African-American students from the state system of higher education are networked all over Pennsylvania for the next 4 years to support Civil War 150. Now, these are living history players, and this equates to flexible employment for college students and a leg up in a new industry for them. The next thing we do is discipline creativity. The council supports artist residencies through the PCA, and we've made nuts and bolts improvements in math scores, and I can prove it. I got books to show it to you. I can follow a cohort of young students, third, fourth, fifth grade, inner city classrooms, and you can see a bump in math scores due to artist residencies. Community dignity. It was the PCA's money that launched world-renowned Caitlin Smiles, the initiative that places free art projects and supplies in the hospital for hospital-bound children. Their very first grant dollars came from the PCA. The Pennsylvania Immigrant and Refugee Women's Network, Community Dignity, started with a PCA grant. This beautiful agency networks displaced women together in peaceful and supportive activities. It's American creativity that's at stake, folks. Think about the first time a ballet student gets on point. First time a kid gets a violin solo, right? The first time a kid figures out non-linear digital editing in his graphics class. Have we discovered new pro artists? No, probably not. Every now and then, maybe. But what we've done is we teach them how to learn. They've learned how to learn. How to be creative and stick with something. This is disciplined creativity. And it will eventually land them a job, help them launch a business, or keep America competitive. So when I speak of the impact of disciplined creativity, I mean it in every sense and every walk of life. So this disciplined creativity, the community dignity, as with Caitlin Smiles, and the workforce development programs that Jump Street runs, this is the essential work that the PCA fosters, organizes, and supports. Without the PCA, Jump Street will survive, but it would be greatly altered, with so many fewer children impacted. We directly impact 200 school students a year, but they create products that reach hundreds of thousands of people. Furniture, radio programs, magazines, as I've mentioned. The PCA is the keystone agency in Pennsylvania for the arts. Let's keep it supported and intact. So much relies on the creativity it fosters. Thanks.
Thank you, Bob. Next, I want to bring up a friend of the arts, a good friend of mine, Julie Hawkins.
So I'll be short here today and just tell you that all of the organizations that the Council on the Arts supports are mission-based. They're nonprofits, and the mission of the arts and the mission of the legislature are really one and the same. It's all about serving the people of Pennsylvania. That's why the Council on the Arts exists, to be that bridge between the state and the arts that enables access to those arts for all Pennsylvanians. The arts are key to the Keystone State, as Bob said. We're growing jobs, enriching education, and supporting communities. You can see those numbers here. In southeastern Pennsylvania, where I'm from, that's 19,000 jobs in that region alone. We're here today because we all care about Pennsylvanians. I trust that our state cares too, and that the Commonwealth is going to continue its $8.2 million investment in the Council on the Arts. This is an agency creating a very large return with a very small investment. It's 0.03% of the entire state budget that we're talking about here. So I'm encouraged by what everybody said today, and I hope that all of your legislative colleagues agree with you. Because for us, arts and culture is how Pennsylvania grows.
Thank you, Julie. Next, I'm going to be bringing up Representative Tony Payton. I also want to acknowledge that Representative Vanessa Brown was in the audience as well. She had to leave, but Representative Payton.
Thank you, Larry, for your leadership on this issue. And arts is life. Arts is imagination. Arts is inspiration. The arts build character. And the arts is passion. And in this day, the arts equal growth. We should invest in it. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative. Again, I want to thank everybody for coming out today. The arts, like Representative said, are important. They're vital. And especially for someone like myself, who actually failed art on numerous occasions. I could never get past the turkey on the hand at Thanksgiving. Sort of reached that point in my artistic career, and I realized it was time to hang it up. But hopefully we're not going to hang it up on this issue right now. But it's important. We need to put the pressure on, and I know that the folks behind me and the folks who are here today and the folks in this building want to continue to fight. So thank you very much for coming out. We appreciate it. Any questions? Any questions? Questions? Okay. Thank you very much.